Hi, I am Sudhir Tyagi from Rajdhani Scientific Instruments Company. Today I am going to explain to the working of infrared moisture balance model RSMA2A. This is RSMA2A. RS stands for Rajdhani Scientific, MA stands for moisture analyzer, and model 2A. So here, as you can see, there are two parts. One is the main instrument unit and one is a control unit. So when you receive this instrument in your laboratory, you will see that this unit will be having this connector, and to ensure whether it has reached to your place safely or not, you have to do a small cross check that I will just tell you. So first I'll cover the installation part. This is the main unit, this is the control unit. To connect this main unit with the control unit, 6-pin connector is given, and on the back side of this control unit you can see here one this port is there for sensor, and where it is specifically written, R stands for red wire, WH1 stands for white wire 1, WH2 stands for white wire 2. These WH1 and WH2 can be interchanged, there won't be any problem. And this is the connector for connecting the main unit. So here we just connect it. It can be connected in one way only. So there is no point. And so in installation, connect this main unit 6-pin connector to the control unit, and then insert this sensor. Here it is the port given for this sensor. We have to just insert it, that's it. So this is all installation part. Now I'll just switch it on, and this is a digital temperature controller, and this is digital temperature timer, 2-digit. Right now it is set for 10 minutes, and we can increase or decrease this timing by pressing these push button given just below this display. Here this is a switch, this is a switch, and if you push this temperature controller 110, it means we have set temperature 110. It will keep on the main bulb till 110 temperature is reached, and this indicates that light is given to the bulb. But as you can see, bulb is not glowing. The main reason is this is a direct heat knob. If we increase it, now the bulb will glow, and you can vary the intensity of bulb also. So right now I have just kept it off, and once this instrument is reached to the laboratory, first of all what we have to do is we have to unlock. This is a lock pin. We keep the instrument in locked condition for transportation purpose only. So once it has reached to your laboratory, just pull this part and rotate it toward this side and just keep it here. Now there is no use of this lock pin. It is used only for transportation purpose. Now this is the sample pen. So to check whether your instrument is in proper condition or not, is there any damage in the transportation? For that you have to see here in the display. This is a dial. You are seeing viewing glass. Three things are visible here. One is the scale 100, as you can see, and on the left of scale 100 there is a horizontal red color line. It is called the reference mark, and it is fixed, and this is the pointer. And as you see that as I press this sample pen by my finger, that pointer is moving freely. So if this thing is happening, it means your instrument is in working condition, it is in okay state, there is no damage during the transportation. So this is a small cross check. That pointer should move up and down freely. So now I'll start about the working of the instrument. First I'll start with the control unit. See, in the control unit, first this is a temperature controller. You keep this push button, keep it pressed, and by rotating it you can set any desired temperature. So generally we keep 110. So here again I am setting 110 temperature. So what this temperature controller will do, till the temperature is reached, suppose I make it on. Now you can see this bulb is on. So I'll just put it down. So this is a temperature sensor. So as I close this compartment, you can see this temperature is increasing. So till 110 temperature is reached, this light indicates that current is given to the bulb, right? And the bulb intensity can be controlled with this knob. So once it has reached to 110, this will cut off supply to the bulb and this light will glow off. So this small light directly indicates the condition of your infrared bulb. Okay, now this is a timer. Here, as you can see, initially we had set 10, so now it is 07. So it is a countdown timer. What happens, wherever this instrument is used in the laboratory, repeated samples are to be tested. So once we test the sample one time, two time, three, four, five time, then we eventually come to know that within a particular time that that sample takes for getting moisture out. So depending on that data, we can set the temperature. Then it will make our this system automized. So suppose a particular sample is taking 10 minutes generally. So we set a time of 10 minutes. So what this timer will do till 10 minutes, it will keep on giving supply to the bulb. Temperature is maintained by temperature controller, and after 10 minutes, it will stop supply to the bulb. And buzz a buzzer that indicates the time has elapsed. Whatever time you had set, it has elapsed. So that the operator can come, if he is doing some other work in the laboratory, he can come and take the reading. So for that buzzer, we have given this optional switch. If you keep it on, then only it will buzz. Otherwise, if you are in front of instrument, you can keep it off also. So now I'll show the working of this main instrument. As you can see, this is the analog instrument. Some pointer knobs and all these things are there. This is just a control unit to make the system automize. Now to operate this instrument, the main parts is, this is the scale dial bulb switch. If I keep it off, then you can see there is no light inside the scale. It is the scale viewing glass. As I turn it on, light glows at the scale, light off, light on. And this is another switch is there. It is a main switch for bulb. Suppose the bulb is glowing. So if I turn it off, then no light will come there. So it is the main switch for bulb. And this is the dial bulb for viewing scale. So two switches are there. There are two black knobs on the right hand side and one at the left hand side. So on the right hand side black knob, it is called a scale knob. And on the left side, this black knob is called pointer knob. So in the main unit, there are two knobs and two switches. One switch is to give supply to the bulb, main bulb switch. This is dial bulb switch. This is scale knob. This is pointer knob. And this is lock pin. And this is sample pan. This is all description of the instrument. Now to start operation, what we have to do is, first we have to bring 100, suppose in this when you rotate the this right hand side knob, this scale will rotate. As you can see, scale is rotating. So first step is, we have to bring 100 of the scale coinciding with the reference mark. This is the first step. And now you can see that as air is flowing, that pointer is moving. So what we do is, we just close this compartment. And now you can see, if the pointer is somewhere above or below, then rotating this left side black color knob, rotating this knob, we have to coincide that pointer knob to the 100 mark or the reference mark. So this is the second step. In the third step, what we will do, we will bring 0 of the scale in front of reference mark. And in doing so, you will see that pointer will go up. You will see pointer is somewhere upside. So we will bring 0. This is the third step. One thing you have to take notice, that we have to rotate this knob slowly. Now this is the 0 of the scale. Now what we will do, now pointer is above reference mark. So when we press this sample pen, you will see that pointer is coming down. So this
Now we have to place sample on the sample pen. Now there is a way how to place sample. As you can see, this is a small pointer on which the sample pen is held. So what we have to do, there is a method, we have to distribute sample all around this sample pen. If you keep it in lump at one side, then this sample pen will not won't be a free sample pen. It will become like this. So we have to distribute the sample all around the center knob of the sample pen so that it remains in horizontal position. One condition is this. Second condition is we have to make a small layer of the sample as thin as possible. Now the main thing is how much sample we have to keep on this sample pen. This instrument tells itself. As you can see, this is a 10 gram model. It means that approximately 10 gram of sample is required. This model gram just capacity, model capacity just inform you how much sample is used in a testing. So if it is 10 gram, then almost approximately 10 gram of sample is used. So if a sample is in powder form, then it is best suited for this application. If it is a hard, then you have to crush it and then distribute it gradually. So we have to place sample on this sample pen so that, as you can see, as I give weight on this sample pen, that pointer will come down. So we have to add that much of sample so that this sample, this pointer coincide with the reference line. And if you placed more sample and pointer goes down the reference line, you can take out the excess sample. So we have to place this much of sample only so that this pointer coincide with the reference line like this. After doing this, this was the fourth. After doing this, we have to close it down and turn on the bulb like this. Now what will happen? Heat is imparted on the sample, temperature of the sample is raised. Once it has reached 100 degree, our sample should be exposed to that temperature of 110 approximately 5 to 6 minutes. This is a basic condition to getting that moisture out. So once the temperature is increased of the sample, that moisture of the sample will become vaporized, because moisture cannot exist at 100 degree Celsius. It has to be vaporized above 100. So in this process, weight of the sample is lost. When the moisture will vaporize, the weight of the sample is definitely going to lose. And as the weight will reduce, that pointer which was set, which was coincided at the reference mark, it will go up and up. So finally, till there is moisture, that pointer will keep on moving very slowly upward. Once moisture is totally vaporized, then you have to rotate this knob again to read the sample. This is the fifth point. All these points are given in the manual also, but the fifth point is very important to how to read the reading. So by rotating this knob, you have to again bring that pointer to the coinciding with the reference mark. So you have to rotate this knob so that scale reading rotate from 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to rotate this way from 0 to towards positive side, 1, 2, 3, 4. By doing so, you will see that pointer will come towards the reference mark. And once it has coincided with the reference mark, that is a direct, that corresponding reading on the scale is a direct percentage of moisture. Now, initially, there is even doubt to the customer that how would I ensure that total moisture has been vaporized or not. So to ensure that, what you do is, once you have done this fifth step, now the pointer is again coinciding with the reference mark, and some reading is there in the scale, suppose 10 or 12 or 15. So you do one thing, you keep the instrument on again, raise the temperature up to 110 degree and keep it there for at least 2-3 minutes. So if there is any moisture left in the sample, then the pointer will again go up. If the pointer remains stable at the stable or coinciding with the reference mark, it means there is no moisture at all. And suppose it has again gone up, Then again, by rotating this knob, you bring that pointer to the reference mark and read the correct reading on the scale. That is the percentage of moisture. So this is all about this instrument. This is just a glass for viewing the sample. And depending upon sample, you can increase or decrease the intensity of this bulb, IR bulb. There is one more thing. It is the standby heat. Standby heat. I would like to explain this thing. See, generally when we have set temperature, as in this case it is 110, right now it is 66 67, it is increasing. If I rotate it, you see the intensity here. If I rotate it clockwise, the intensity is more, the rate of increase is higher. So what will happen after 110, when this temperature control switch off the supply to the bulb, that bulb will go to the zero state. Just 1 second before, it was giving full intensity of light, and once the temperature is reached, it will just become zero, from highest intensity to the zero. So in that case, it that temperature decreases very fast, and again it gives turn on the bulb. So in that case, bulb will switch very fast, turn on, turn off, turn off, turn on, turn off. So to avoid that situation, we have given this standby heat. So once this has started action, this has stopped. Just I will show after when this 110, it is going to be going off at 110 like this, and you see bulb is off. Now what we do is we supply a small heat there at this position like this. You see, now it has turned on 110 off. And you will see it will go down again on. So to avoid this thing, fast switching of the bulb, what we have done is we have given this standby heat knob. See, now this is off. Now I will just start it, and you can see I have to give only small. Now this is the fast intensity, this is through this, and now when it is 110, it is not zero, some light is there. So we can, if I just increase the small light, that it will not switch from on to off, on to off. It will switch from on to small light, on to small light. So that way you can control this temperature very precisely. One thing you have to remember very carefully is that the intensity, now when this is off, the intensity of the bulb should be very small. It should not be higher. If it is higher, then it will keep on increasing the temperature. First, I will suggest you keep this position to off position. You work the instrument completely. When you do this thing for 4, 5, 10 times, then you can understand the working of this standby heat very easily. Even if it is in off position, then the instrument will work properly. It is just an additional feature. You should use this feature after understanding the instrument, after using the instrument. So this is a PT100 type sensor. This is a PT100 type sensor, and special port is there. Now you can see. So this is all about infrared moisture balance. Thank you.